I'm Jean-François Reynaud. I'm working on the CEO of GeoZyris, and I think the presentation today will be to explain how we are on the way to build an OSDU RescueML shared Earth modeling workflow platform and working with that together with RescueML and OSDU together. In fact, we are a small innovating company. I think maybe all of you don't know what is GeoZyris at all. And in fact, we founded this company a few years ago from myself, from AFP, Energie Nouvelle, and other PhD and people from École des Mines de Paris. And in fact, we have worked on web architecture, cloud, AI, knowledge management, geometry, and topology. And what we want to do is to facilitate shared Earth modeling approach between several companies. In fact, we intend to promote the combination of cloud available microservices orchestrated, choreographed by cloud native platform. In fact, it's really something on which OSDU is wanting to go. And in fact, we wrote a book on that part, let's say around 10 years ago before. The domain on which we are working, it's mainly of the RescueML domain. Which is the reservoir modeling domain, in fact, for OSDU. And in fact, we can work on different entities coming from interpretation to structural framework and reservoir characterization, Bayesian modeling, and reservoir dynamic simulation. We cover element on subsurface exploration. We are working also with geotechnic companies for roads, railway, tunnels, etc. We could apply that to carbon capture, to fluid flow simulation into rock volume, what we did in an ancient history, and geological risk assessment and quantification of environmental disease. So what we are doing really, we are working on data handling tools, and we have some tools around RescueML, which are able to manipulate the information, validate, and we have APIs, and we rely on development service. We facilitate, in fact, this time the use of energy sticks, what is done in OSDU Forum, and also with BPMN exchange standard. So our thing is, as a plus, we have a geomodeling business activity. This business activity has mainly involved to create implicit or explicit 2 and 3D object representation from seismic, by example, or for other implementation. And also, this element tolerates the transformation, which can be induced by geological evolution through time, and we can mainly furnish that after in a workflow. But let's say, in the GeoZyris and OSDU Forum, what we are doing, as our historical domain is Earth modeling, and because we were working with energy sticks, in fact, we are onboarded in the OSDU Forum in the early 2020. As our objective is to federate the small vendors and build a shared Earth modeling workflow platform, could be open also, using this standard, we actively participate to several forum workgroups: the reservoir data definition, the data loading and ingestion, the core concept, the reservoir DDMS, and a little to the enterprise architecture design on the side for the time being. And we did that because, in fact, in the ORDU, we have one of the earliest contributors to the reservoir domain. We started, by example, with Emerson, with Exxon, and others to work on that part and TotalEnergies. And we are one of the first working on this domain. We did that to accumulate the necessary expertise in order to develop the product on this base, in fact. And at the end, we'd like to propose an innovative cloud native workflow for geomodeling, which could be shared by many companies at the end. The first result of our work is our contribution to the data definition workgroup. In fact, we work to be sure that we have a complementarity between the RescueML V2.2, which is not ready, but will be issued by the OSDU Forum these days, the open group these days, and the OSDU 1.1. And we are sharing the same metadata design at a high level. You have RESQML feature, which are mainly master data in OSDU. You have RESQML interpretation, representation, property activities, which are in fact work package component in OSDU. We have RESQML relationship, which are translated in kind ID reference link and reference in OSDU. And RESQML enums, property kind, quantity class, unit of measure, which are part of the reference data. So all these parts could consider to be the metadata part of the RESQML. But on the RESQML, you have a complement with the detailed representation of numerical value, which is handled for the time being by HDL5 files, but could be handled after in OSDU, in a Postgres database like is done in the Emerson RDDMS system, or in a HSDS server if we use it as an external data store system. We handle here the topology in the representation entities. We handle the geometry and property, and we handle also geometry and form, the result of a key period of the geomodeling life cycle, and be able to share it with between applications. So what we are doing now, we are generating geomodeling application. In fact, we did that on Volve, that's done. We export the information into a RESQML ETP server. We use ETP server collection with a consistent set of RESQML entities to be able to ingest all this information. We get this XML instance from the ETP server collection and put that by the dataset service into the dataset. And we create now the tool, which is RESQML to OSDU converter, which is able to create master data, work package component, dataset, and other things like that. So this thing also is ingested because we did all this ingesting with a script, which is the manifest by reference, and we also pass validation integrity. So in a summary, in that, we have this extraction, which is showing manifest main structure on which you can have the kind system, the reference data, master data, the work product component, and data set. So you can see here that we are not just talking, but really working in deep and executing what is necessary to be done by all the system into OSDU. And for that, I will show you just after the different manifests proposed from a RESQML collection. And I will go very quick in order to just show you how it works. But you will be back after. If you want, you can have a look and check if everything is fine for you, etc. So by example, you can show the master data and have here, by example, the relationship between this master data and the UUID in RESQML. So any OSDU object and RESQML object has the same ID and can be checked and exchanged together. They have also an identical version number in order to have a complete relationship between them. And then we have information about the data set on which we put this master data. And what could be interesting to look is the result of the collection, which in fact transported into a work product component. And you have the list, by example, of what we have in RESQML and the same view in OSDU. So we have that on local boundary feature with the same thing. We can have a horizon interpretation, and here is very interesting because all the metadata, which is interesting to be captured by the OSDU, is stored here. The same on the fault interpretation. And you have a way to represent information about the generic interpretation, and that's the way to go and see if you come back, you have all the information of the side of all the file you can collect after at the end.
And who are the data folks be? I mean, do you think between Jill, who can help us out with the actual connectivity of OSDU, like permissions and the tags that she's helped us out with?
Yeah, that's fine.
Sorry, thank you.
I can come back after if you want all the things, yeah? Because we have just explained that in detail after. So the data set here and the interpretation ID, by example, here it's the link from the representation to the data, to the interpretation. And the indexable element count on which you have the number of information into the system. We have the data set, and the data set, we use this system on the data set find generic. And in fact, we have the link between the whole EPC container with HDF5 or the link to the XML file containing the metadata in the RESQML file. This is ready to be, delivered after. When we pass the validation, we pass our script together and we have the validation on which we successfully validated all what we did and also have a test on the integrity on which we have done the integrity test coming into the system. So what we're doing exactly? So that's some proof of concept implementation we have started to work on. So we have a technical short-term objective, which is to realize what we have done with this manifest creation in several contexts for ingestion. The first one will be to have RESQML EPC plus HDF5, so coming directly from the application and ingestion into the OSD platform. The second will be to pass through a V2.2 ETP server used as an external data store. And at the end, to complete by search and delivery from OSDU data platform and using ETP APIs. So our technical mid and long-term objective is to connect OSDU data platform to all components of Earth modeling workflow. And the overall objective is to develop the partnership to strengthen this solution with other people working in OSDU. So what we see is just we have a geomodeling application. We send an EPC plus H5 in a RESQML 2.2. We can also edit, create a collection, enrich with property, and create the record into the data set and the complete manifest, put that in the OGCM by Airflow DAX. That is for the application coming directly for existing now. So if we have a RESQML ETP server, which is like a RDDMS, in fact. We take a collection, put this collection in our converter, go to manifest, and send the manifest to the ingestion by Airflow DAX. It's the demo you have seen just before. And now, if we want to go back, we have this search and delivery from the OSDU platform. This select the center number of work package component element. And in fact, we will have an OSDU to SQML corrector, which is only create a collection. And as everything is already known with this address in the SQML server, it will be delivered to the application. So the end of the story is we want to experiment the progressive replacement of that, of monolithic operation. So we take this ID of the OSDU forum and working on the competing file, but not only, because we work also on the API, etc. We have developed a RESQML domain management system based on RESQML, a system to be able to compute some services, to orchestrate the workflow, and some user interface. That will be after, at the end, the Osiris workflow platform. So as a conclusion, in fact, we are working to federate, in fact, shared Earth model activity by exchanging OSDU at energistics entities. The objective after will be to aggregate small vendor activities to compete against monolithic proprietary workflow by a combination of this orchestrated microservice in a cloud native workflow. So when we started with OSDU Forum, it was fine because you see that as a game changer, and we started to participate, and it was a very good opportunity. because we contribute to ensure the complementarity between OSQML and OSDU, which is important for us. OSDU broader, wider, safer, and more universal cloud strategy in a larger ecosystem than we had before. And it is an opportunity to collaborate with partners and customers. Oui, bref, now I take my breath. And for more detail after on our future workflow platform, we will present something which is more detailed at the EAGA in Madrid, which is a cloud native standard by geoscientific workflow architecture for improving geomodeler collaboration. So I thank you very much to listen me to the end. And I think, I hope I could have somebody interested to follow up what we are doing in the presenting in the next EAGA annual show.